The pitch. Fly ball! Center field! It's all over! It's all over! The Reds win it! The Reds win it! The Reds win it! A home run to center field by Tony Perez! The Reds win it! The Reds win it! 14-13! Perez with a home run to center field! The Reds have scored five times in the ninth inning! And the Reds win on a Tony Perez home run to center field! Oh my golly! Holy cow, what a finish!
With the tying runs on and nobody out, Griffey second, Davey first. The strike one pitch, swung on and hit into deep center field. Way back, it is going to be, this one belongs to the Reds! Tony Perez has hit a home run to dead center field, and the Reds have done it again. As Perez hit one over the 404 marker in straightaway center field, and Cincinnati has pulled it out of the ninth inning by a final score of 8-7. Oh, boy. Bench is back in, and Reed serves it up. Swung on, fly ball, deep left center field. Maddox on the warning track, looking up. It's gone. Johnny Bench with a home run to left center, and the Reds have tied it up on back-to-back ninth inning home run. They're on their feet at Riverfront, and it is tied at 6 runs apiece. Underwood with a slow come down to the belt. He throws. Griffey swings. Slow chopper. Right side. Here comes Concepcion. Poland boots the ball. And the 1976 pennant belongs to the Reds. It was a high chop along the first baseline. Bobby Tolan could not come up with it cleanly. Concepcion scores, and it is pandemonium down on the field. As the Reds have scored 3 in the ninth inning, and have swept the Philadelphia Phillies to move into the 1976 World Series. Fans standing all over the ballpark as the Philadelphia Phillies went to the bottom of the ninth, leading by 2 runs, and boy, what a comeback by the big red machine.
Danny Dreesen holding his ground at first base, and here's a pitch to Bench. Swung on and hit deep left field. That might be his second of the game. It's gone, a home run. Johnny Bench with his second home run of the night.
Got speed at first base in Jerry Mumphrey and blistering speed at the plate in Gary Templeton. It would be very tough to double him up. Knight now about even with a bag at third, but creeping in slowly as Seaver comes back to Templeton. Bouncing ball, shortstop, Concepcion. Morgan will hold the throw at second base as they get the force out on Mumphrey. 2 away in the Cardinal ninth inning, and Seaver is 1 out away. The batter is George Hendrick as they start to their feet here at Riverfront Stadium. Seaver, 1 out away from the first no-hitter of his major league career and what would be the 14th in the long history of the Cincinnati Reds. George Hendrick, big, strong, right-handed batter, has gone hitless in 3 times. He has struck out once. Seaver pitches. Hendrick takes a strike. The crowd begins to roar with every pitch. Mumphrey has been forced at second. Templeton, the runner at first, 2 out. The strike one pitch coming to Hendrick. He swings and pops it foul, but it's going to be out of play as Donnie Warner runs to the near end of the Cincinnati dugout, and it falls back in the stand. Strike two. There has never been a no-hit game pitched by a Cincinnati Reds pitcher here at Riverfront. The last Reds no-hitter thrown was back on the 30th of April, 1969, by Jim Maloney at Crosley Field. He no-hit the Houston Astros 10-0. Seaver is a strike away. He stretches. He checks the runner. He pitches. He pitches high a fastball, and it's 1-2. They are standing all over the ballpark. Hendrick waiting on Seaver's 1-2 pitch. Tom sets, he kicks and fires. He pops it up, and it's going to be out of play, directly back of the plate. So Tom Seaver, now a strike away from his first major league no-hitter. The Reds leading at 4-0 in the ninth inning. Hendrick puts ahead of the bat on the plate. Werner hangs the sign. Seaver with a pause, the check and the pitch. He bounces to first base. Friesen has it. He goes to the bag, and Seaver's got it. Bob Seaver has pitched his first major league no-hitter, and this one belongs to the Reds. Seaver is being mobbed at first base as George Hendrick bounces a routine two-hopper to Danny Dreesen, and the 38,216 at Riverfront Stadium are standing.
They are all up and on their feet and rooting individually and collectively for Browning to get one final out. He is ready for the 2-2 to Woodson, and here it comes. And it is swung out and missed. And Tom Browning has pitched a perfect game. 27 outs in a row, and he is being mobbed by his teammates just to the third base side of the mound. A perfect game thrown by Tom Browning on this Friday night, September the 16th, 1988, as he no-hits the Los Angeles Dodgers 1-0 and throws the first perfect game in the long and legendary history of this great Cincinnati Reds baseball franchise. And now Browning being hoisted to the shoulders of his teammates. And boy, what a memorable scene on a wet, dreary evening here in Cincinnati. A night that the fans had to wait 2 hours and 27 minutes for. And brother, was the wait worthwhile. And this one belongs to the Reds.
The pitch. And a high drive. Hit back into deep right field. Junior has just knocked the door down to the 500 club. A high drive into the lower deck and right. Number 30 touches them all. And boy, what a Father's Day gift for Senior. The dugout empties as he rounds third, getting the glad hand from Mark Berry. Greeted at home plate by Adam Dunn. Now Jason LaRue, followed by Sean Casey. And each of them will get a piece of Ken Griffey Jr. before he gets back into the dugout, hitting his 500th home run to right field. Leading off this sixth inning, and last but not least, manager Dave Miley. And now Junior running down toward the area where his mom and dad sit, and he is there with his father for a big Father's Day hug. What a scene this is here at Busch Stadium in St. Louis.